Hello everyone, greetings, welcome back to Let's Play Heroes of Might and Magic 7. Last time, yesterday, we finished Jorgen over here, that guy. Now we're going for the guy I don't know. I mean, Jorgen I remember from Heroes 6, of course, so, yeah. Anyway, we head into the campaign. We'll just, as I said, we'll just go this way. Even though it does mean that we'll probably play a little Haven after each other. With a bit of luck, this is just the Haven icon over there, as you can see. Wish I could point at the screen with my finger, but it doesn't help. Can see both of these are the same icon, so perhaps they're Haven, perhaps they aren't. Anyway, we're going with Lazier over here. I'm gonna play some Sylvan.
I would tell you the story of an odyssey, about a chosen leader who no one wanted and no one expected.
So no one wants this, eh? All right, this is all fine. We're not gonna change that. Reset campaign is irrelevant. So we have four missions. Let's go.
Regardless of what I do next, there's something we cannot overlook. Seamus has the support of the Church of Light, and I do not.
Many within the Church are on our side, Duke Ivan. When the moment comes, they will be behind you.
I certainly hope so, Murizel, and I appreciate your efforts to rally them to our cause. But what of Elrath? So far he has been silent. But maybe that's because he's fine with the idea of Seamus sitting on the throne. What can I hope to achieve if the dragons have already ordained our fates?
No fate but what hand makes.
The Orc Kente is right, my lord. The dragons' ways are mysterious, and it is often difficult to grasp the full extent of their actions. I was wondering what kind of advice I could offer you, my lord, but I seem to recall an elven tale that would fit the matter at hand.
Rowena of Unicorn speaks highly of you, Lysir. I would hear your story.
Alright, there we go. Oh, creatures cannot have less than minus 50 morale. That's the worst news I have heard all day. Just get that something we're never gonna get. Never gonna go for, because... Well... It's good to know, I mean, it's also plus 50.
My ladies and lords are all familiar with the people we call the Shaldan.
The Sea Elves.
Indeed. Our seaborn cousins who wander the oceans of Ashen. I want to tell you the story of a young Shaldan. To outsiders, he was known as Wisloth, or simply Wis. Wisloth was the eldest son of a famous captain and great hero, Osrath Ilrian. Now, Osrath Ilrian was getting old and intended to retire. It was no secret he would appoint Wis as his successor. Nobody had asked Wisloth what he wanted. If they had, they would have known he had no interest in taking his father's place. What place did he crave for himself, you ask? Well, Wisloth had not figured that out yet. And it seems the dragons had grown bored of waiting for him to make a choice. As all sea elves, Wis was an expert sailor and a great swimmer. But Shalassa was so angry that night that even he was struggling not to drown. The last thing he saw before losing consciousness was his ship being swallowed by the storm. How many days did Wisloth drift with only hunger and thirst as companions? One day, he woke up lying on the sands of an unknown shore. Rather than cursing the dragons, he was grateful to be alive. Silana and Shalassa had shown mercy. Curious to see where fate had landed him, Wisloth set out to explore.
There we go, we gotta reenact the story! Yeah, okay, let's see what we got here. So if this guy over here, he's nice as sitting on the beach. He has braids and stuff, it's nice, he's a might hero. This guy cannot die. We have to explore all our surroundings. Gotcha. I did find the sound a little bit low though. Not sure what that was all about. Okay, let's see what we got here. Yeah, you're nothing. Really? You have nothing? Oh, there we go. What's the sea warfare ability? Do I have navigation? No. Will we get navigation? Probably a good one for this one. Alright, Nature's Revenge. I guess I should go over that. It basically... I mean, this I know. So you just get marks at the end of the turn or the standard turn, like stuff happens. I mean, you get like bonus attack, and here you have 2 marks, 3 marks, and depending on what other abilities you get. I mean, like, minus movement is quite decent. And a double ballista attack. I don't know. Leadership, defense, and nature defense, revenge are the ultimates. We'll just go over this for starters and go with their... we get extra magic. Motor trees, renewal ability. So this is all warfare stuff. The stupid thing is that we don't even get warfare all the way to master. So there's like no way we're getting this because these things scale terribly. We've already seen that in the dungeon campaign. Expert level 3 warfare unit doesn't put a dent in anything. So it's absolutely pointless to go for warfare. Unless I'm missing like something that's exploitable, if there is such a thing, don't hesitate to tell me. Maybe we'll give it a shot then, but otherwise I'm not gonna bother. Yeah, this one for example is very strong. That's like 50 earth damage. It doesn't skill once again, but it should skill. So that would be just great, but unfortunately it's a little bit more on the trend of the old heroes that stuff like this doesn't skill. So with this up 3 marks, I don't think this gives extra marks, does it? This is just extra, sure, critical hit on stuff with 3 marks. It's alright. We should have a lot of luck anyway, I think. We have to think about what magic... Oh, we don't have a main magic school in here. Okay. This could be annoying to do then, I think. Anyway, yeah, we'll see about it. Because these are only small Wii schools. We'll probably have to go for Earth here for some lightning voltage. So I do like more offensive spells. Other than that, yeah, you can only have 3 marks, so this is only going to go up to 150. I don't think that skills at all. That is, let's see. So we basically have reinforcements on everything. That's super strong. So I think this is the one we're going to go for first. Because not losing troops is absolute super in the long run. Just not having this 5% attrition. Seems pretty good, the goddamn strong. And the rest we've all seen. Defense. Makes sense. Not sure if that's going to be really needed. Flanking is reduced. 6 defense versus ranged. I don't know. I don't think we'll use a lot of defense, so not sure that will be helpful. We'll probably be on assault a lot. We also have a lot of ranged troops in this faction. We have the druids, the hunters, and the treants. If we go for the treants, we could go for the dragons as well. We'll think about this for a bit. Well, this is happening. That's super strong. Yeah, that's fair. It's meh. Exploration is, of course, important. Maybe we'll go war cries. Would be nice to see this. Maybe we can see this in the... What do we have actually? There's absolutely nothing in our spellbook. I wanted to check. Can we get like in here somewhere and see what all the war cries do? Yeah, it doesn't look like it. There's just some lore stuff in there. So we don't have actually know what these war cries do exactly. I think one of them increases. I think we'll just go for war cries then. Let's give it a shot. Alright. We're gonna explore our surroundings. That means that we are probably gonna stick to the coast a little bit here. Alright. Hello, friendly unicorn.
The first creature Wisloth came across was a lone unicorn, grazing under the cool shadows of the trees. To Wisloth's surprise, the majestic animal offered to become his mount. Where there are tame unicorns, there are often elves.
You know, this story is starting to sound somewhat familiar. Are there white tigers next?
There will be no tigers in this story, Duke Ivan, but I can promise you some surprises.
I like surprises. Okay, so we have a mount, that's good. I don't think there's anything else there. We'll hit this alt button. Too scouting range this early, I'm gonna regret this, ain't I? Not anymore, because we can capture these.
Next, Wisloth came across a herd of twilight stags, moving silently through the forest. Wisloth decided to follow the stags, as they seemed to beckon him along.
I guess they don't want to join me. Let's see if he does. Will I waste my turn? I have a feeling that it will continue running. Okay, let's just pick this stuff up. Let's play that combat out, shall we? Get some experience in here. You look extremely freaking slow. Yep. We'll fix that in a bit. So if we do this, then okay, I speed it like, I don't know, something like this. Combat speed about double. Animation speed about double. It's not really the last chance if you wait, is it? These guys have cleave. We've seen these before, so. How much health do they have? 23. Take the full flank here. We'll lose one guy, I think. No, we don't. Oh, man, yeah, we will, because this guy will kill. Freaking CLs! Stop being weak. This should increase our chance a little bit here. Don't like this, these odds on here. I don't think that's guy's average. That guy will probably be, oh no. 25, these are doing like 30 damage for 4 attack versus 2 defense. Unlimited retaliations, that's not a big deal. 28 initiative. So this thing will be quicker. 4 to 6 times 3 is 12. Is that worth extra scouting? Not really. I think it's best to just see if we can capture this thing, because... yeah, we can't, can we? Yeah. This should be an alright fight. Yeah, not that alright. He's gonna reach in 2 turns anyway. What's gonna do is lure him about a bit. So full flank, we will kill it. Most likely. But I think I'll take another attack here. We can't reach them. We're gonna have to take the level up, I was gonna say, but then I misclicked. Yeah. creatures cannot perform ranged attacks? That sounds terrible. Now suddenly these things should be much more... We can handle these things much better. Yeah, we'll take the time to get in there. No retaliation, 42. This is of 130, inspiring presence. So stuff around this has a lot of extra luck. But it's the 130 health we're gonna care about here. Versus 16 defense. This seems fun. Alright. Got it. That's our level up. So as I said, we'll probably get the leadership up first. Magic isn't going to help me much. If these three tiers, basically have like five tiers now, or full levels, I can't go all the way. I mean, I don't play with my tiers a lot, so forgive me. Although, probably, no, defense on this is probably better with these small troops in here. This is a helmet, isn't it? Yeah, can't even use it. We'll take it for the experience, though. Have to make sure that the position is like this. See, I don't know what these guys are gonna do. Okay, he did the proper attack here. That's why I hit my guys over there. So we can do this attack. Perhaps get bad morale? Nope. Well, retaliation doesn't do anything, so... So I'm gonna take the defense hit here. 28 defense is quite difficult to get through. Yeah! Punch! Punched them full of holes. We did it for the experience. Everything for experience. I guess these poisonous spiders are the scary in here. So these things at top here. 28 hit points. Oh, they have the same amount of hit points. Huh. This almost kills one fully. guy's a beast of freaking morale. It's unbelievable. Yeah, you tell him. So we're getting experience. Oh, that sprite's down there. Yeah. Alright, so as advertised, we'll take the extra health in here. That should be very helpful for these small guys we have.
The stags led Wisloth and his mount to a small clearing. Pixies and spirits were dancing around a standing stone, half covered in moss and plants. Though he was a sea elf, Wisloth knew enough about the customs of the elves living on land to recognize a dragon line stone, marking an underground river of dragon blood. The source of all magic. If there were other elves nearby, then he might well find them at the convergence of the dragon lines, where the power would be strongest.
Yeah, that's where I expect them to. Alright. Except, so we have some sprites. Don't dismiss them, silly. 11 health, 14 now, so that's basically 25% more health on them. That's why I wanted that stuff immediately. And we're of course sitting on a solid 5 defense. These things have retaliation. They can be retaliated, yeah. 42 initiative. Pretty ridiculous. I can't actually use anything with this. Alright. I probably want to head over here. You modest. See how modest that is. I feel that my things can tank these things quite well. For quick combo, I'm probably gonna lose stuff. Yeah. I mean, it's the first time we get the sprites. See the sprites in action. We'll put everything together here for some fun stuff. 55 to 45. Okay. Oh, these guys can reach, huh? Probably have to start attacking these things. 54 versus 18 defense. Shouldn't do that much. I'd like to do this. This is a full flank that turns them this one. I think I'll take the defense hit here instead of knocking two more damage off here. One health. Some health. To take these few hits here to avoid losing anything important. Yeah, that's not gonna happen. We're gonna need that guy, I think, to fully deal with this stuff. So we have to play that out better somehow. We have to actually attack this time, I think. Okay. So both these guys can hit him. Yeah, I'm gonna lose stuff here then. That's not good. Like swarm these things then. Probably some sprites. Oh no. Hate these things way more, it looks like. Yep. So if this thing wants to tank, then I'll take it. Ah, a flank. Yeah. Alright, so the full flank is over here, but it makes more sense to have this guy taken. That's much better. I don't know if I need the gold. Let's assume we don't. Alright, so defense here is done. What's in here? Not gonna care for that yet. Let's start getting to leadership. So we're gonna spread our stuff a little bit here. No. Oh. Interesting. Oh, friends. These are the weak does. I'm gonna call them. These guys look nice and tanky. Do I have to fight that guy? Or maybe it's my new friend. Yeah. Alright, these things have 120. They don't have the inspiring presence. What's the other thing you have? Unfettered. Yeah, that's alright.
Traveling from stone to stone, Wisloth eventually reached a stone circle. This was what Wisloth had been looking for. A nexus of the dragon lines. As he approached the monument, Wisloth noticed a figure sitting next to the largest stone, meditating. The woman, dressed in the robes of a druid, was probably not older than him, despite her silvery hair. She observed Wisloth as he dismounted, piercing him with her amber eyes. There was a pride and defiance in her gaze, but Wisloth also sensed something else. A deep, familiar loneliness.
Aww.
You are not of my people.
My name is Wisloth. I was on a ship. I fell overboard during a storm, and I followed the dragon lines here.
You are a Sheldon. We haven't seen your kind this far north for many, many moons.
I don't want to burden you with my plight. Is there a port nearby? I've been walking for days.
I believe Felista did most of the walking.
Felista? The unicorn?
If she likes you, I shall trust you. Follow me to my camp, Sheldon.
Thank you, my lady. Can you tell me where we are? Is this Irulan?
This is the Twilight Archipelago. You are farther from home than you imagine.
So it seems. And where would that be? Over to the north? And we're going south, because we're rebels. No! This is the place I want to be. There's a gold mine. You know, this sounds like a freaking genius idea. Oh, there's a city over there. With a quick combat there, I'm probably going to lose a billion troops. Yes. But we have some good tanks here now, so... okay. Oh, you're far away. 55 to 63. These things are probably the dangerous ones in terms of pure tech damage. Yeah, so I'll work on this. 18 defense should be perfectly fine. We'll do this. Yeah, you're gonna punch him. Alright. They're all gonna punch the deer. Oh, this thing's for you to go for this one. Yep. Not really interested in attacking with these, then. We'll take both the retaliations. Two full flanks here. I'll still take this guy. Defend was better there. Worth exploring here, and we get extra experience in a gold mine. Yeah, now we lose the gold mine because we're not allowed. Not gonna care about that stuff. Well, I'll take a little peek over here. Oh, well, don't do that. Just a regular save game is fine. This could be annoying because he has ranged. See where he shoots at. Sprites, maybe? No, he's going for the biggie. Oh, he didn't move, so he got deep frozen. Okay. Okay, that guy can reach, so we're just gonna worry about the big stuff here. I'll take the full flank here. This guy shouldn't be able to do anything. Yeah, this thing will also attack. These guys will probably also go to Fado. Oh, that's 54. So this guy doesn't get the same thing. Five to seven, four to six. I have to take this out, I think. I'll probably lose this guy then. That's not good. Oh my god, can you stop that? Yeah. Let's fill them all in here. Since these guys don't actually move this turn. That should give me a little extra defense here. Yeah, I'll survive. It's a good morale charge in there, I think. Yeah. This thing has a 125. Yeah, they're all going for the deer. As long as I'm careful with her, I'm fine here. Attack. I'll free this guy up again. This attack is better. Yeah, got only three of them. Oh my god, can you stop critting? Is there a way I cannot have this thing die? Do I care? I should probably care. Alright. Now, fuck it. We're done. I'm done. There, you'll be missed. Go for the gold this time. It's really dumb to lose this, but take the three Loros. We'll get over to the city now. Let's go do that. I assume I get the city, right? Don't worry about this stuff back there.
Lady Danon, who is this stranger?
Everything's fine, Surreal. Felista has found another castaway. This one seems to be a Sheldon.
Wisloff, at your service.
A sea elf, eh? Maybe Solana put you on our path to get us out of our predicament.
A shipwrecked sailor doesn't inspire much confidence.
Anyone can be thrown to the sea in a storm. What is your predicament?
We are castaways, Sheldon. Just like you.
We were on our way to Dragonmist Island when our ship was caught in a maelstrom and crashed on the reefs north of here. We built new ships, but they were sunk. A tribe of Cyclops controls what comes and goes from the island. From the top of their cliffs.
Cyclops? They can be tricky. Are there not enough of you to oust them from their perch?
Short of climbing the cliff, which would be suicide, the only way to reach them would be for a few brave souls to sail through the maelstrom again and moor on the other side of the island.
I don't know if Providence or the dragons truly put me on this island, but neither Cyclops nor a maelstrom are going to keep me here.
All right. Yeah. Okay, we have her as well now. Level 4 and level 5. We also have a city. We can't build a lot of slings in here. But we can build a lot of creatures. But we have like zero ways to get money. The Mage Guild has to get up to level 2 is for sure here. We need to get some spells. Is that prior or not? We won't get dark spells, I think. Maybe we can. The Face of Fear would be quite useful. We're going for troops first, might be an idea. Can even get these things, nice. Spells or troops, eh? We level 2. Okay. Since we're gonna need that thing anyway, let's get it in here too. It's just stats, 40. It's nothing. Can't you be friends? Don't really have a way to teleport anything in there, but we can pick up some mines with this guy. She will need the stat-ups, all the stat-ups as well. She has some ranged troops. That's nice. I'll probably combine actually with the other one. We'll just have this guy as main hero for now. She can pick up all this stuff. All the unguarded stuff, like... This is guards in it. Oh, some moon doe over there. Spiders over there. How do you match up to these guys? Ugh, that's a lot of them. We'll definitely have to go for the gold here. Oh, it loops around down here. Okay. I'm gonna get gold first. We have a gold mine ticking, so that helps a lot. Stat up here. And an ore mine, ore pit, just what we need. It's a really weak artifact. All stuff we can pick up down there. That's a gold mine. We're taking that. Alright, let's continue with hunters. Alright, this should be alright. We should have tank enough units here to deal with this. You can't be in a wall. What the hell are you doing? Super weird position, but we'll take it. Alright, we still don't have anything in here. Let's see how much this thing hurts. Yeah, 90 damage. So good. Wait. Just gonna wait for these guys to get closer. Wow. Eight attack. These guys are elite. Seven defense. So he's gonna do more than this. So even if I kill one, I'll lose two. That's not good enough. Will this guy actually go for the druids, I wonder? Probably will, won't he? Well, in that he's gonna vex up these things. I wanna see what he goes for. Yeah, he's going for druids. Okay. So did I make a mistake? Definitely made a mistake. Should probably replay this again. Because these druids were terribly positioned. I don't like this. I'm not playing this. I'm not playing well to them. We'll see if they get in a row. That'd be nice. Could hit both with these. Nah, that's impossible. Actually, these guys are gonna get irrelevant soon, so I'll just use them. Do these guys actually do? Yeah, they have a proper flying attack. Don't know if this hurts my own troops. Doubt it, but not here to try that. All right, that's good to know. He hates pirates. Cause yeah, I don't want this thing to move anywhere important, so. Got it. Let's get in here. That's the one I want. That's actually quite good. Extra gold mine for us. Alright, let's keep making them troops. What do we need for this? Dragon steel, eh? Okay. Figures. Kinda want this upgraded. $2,000 gold. Another gold mine over here, guarded by champions though. I've got this. Go back, pick it up. End of the week. So the question is, do we want 20 extra of these or extra these? I'll go for extra these. Oh, take you. Take these guys too. So far, so good. Gonna need two of this. We're gonna need a mage guild for druid, so level two even. Oh, we can specialize it. Let's see here. Okay, we have nature for sure. The question is, do we want light or air magic? Dark magic is also an option. What's excluded? Nothing is excluded, so we can actually get anything we want. The question is, what do we want? We have some opportunity to... Actually, that reminds me, we should check this other hero we have. We haven't actually checked. Like, our skills. Extra earth magic skills, basically. And she's already an expert at it. when she has the reduced mana cost instead of the AoE stone skin or regeneration. What other magic do we get? We have the opportunity for prime magic. Earth magic we already have. Air and water is the alternative. She needs paragon. That's great. I like getting this. You what? So this skill basically means that we should at least get points in all this. Because that just makes... This is powerful. Wow. And this is 15% extra health on everything. So we have some good stuff to look out for on this hero. This hero seems to be quite powerful. But as I said, it doesn't mean we should get at least these things on basic. So the cost of master rank. A master rank is not a serious business. That's top rank, as you can see. Okay. Gotcha. So the specialization in the Mage Guild is going to be... Even though I kind of like light, just to get the heal in there for resing purposes. I have a feeling we'll run into heal at some point, so... However, we're not going to get air anytime soon, or prime. Since we have to get Paragon fully done anyway. Alright, let's make sure we at least increase the chance we get it. Now we got Sunbeam. At least I think it's level 1 spell. Can't get this. Ah, that's cheap. High tier troop. Why do I need to visit this? I think getting the gold mine early is probably better. I'm not gonna like this, but let's do it. Alright, what else did I not pick up? Guess she can go down there and pick up some of this rubbish. Not sure how this works, but okay, it's green. One wood and one ore. Or mystic pump. Neither, we're gonna get a level 2 mage guild. This costs so great. Wood. Maybe heals level 2? No. But a lightning bolt at least. Okay. Feeling that this guy can't learn it. 3-0. But this guy's never gonna learn spells, is he? He isn't. Not soon, at least. Oh well. 2. Because again, these are top tiers of 400. We have a lot of health to work through here. Oh my god, you did a lot of damage. Is not a lot of damage. So I have to start sacrificing some troops here. How many of these are we gonna lose? 7. Maybe it'll be alright. 240. 61 health. Let's see what these guys are going for. It's probably gonna move over here and fly. Oh, I can read my druids! God damn it. I should pay attention. This happens way too often here. It's not worth for the gold mine, I suppose. So let's do it. Not sure how modest these guys are. Doesn't look like they will be joining us either, so. But now we're making 2.5k, and that's like the best we can do because we can't actually upgrade our main building. Main gold building. As in our town hall can't be upgraded.